Hurriyat leaders rounded up by the NIA after Times Now exposed a massive funds for terror scandal on May 6 have begun to sing like canaries in custody. Remember, Times Now has accessed probe reports that broke the code of silence, revealing a startling payoff for protection plan and a bribe for blackout scandal. Let's get to the hard facts without any delay on this story. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, that precisely 11 weeks ago, 77 days back in time, on May 6, Times Now had linked the Hurriyat to terror financing. We had told you that the Hurriyat receives money from Pakistan's deep state, the ISI, money that comes in and is dispersed by Hurriyat to various individuals in the valley and organizations which have been banned and deemed terror organizations by the Indian state. For some, these people continue to be stakeholders. That money goes out there and then spawns anti-national activities that bleeds India through a strategy of a thousand cuts that has been, of course, evolved, honed and fine-tuned in Pakistan. That's why we call the Hurriyat Pakistan's dalals. But today, we are taking this expose further. In my hands are documents which have been accessed by Times Now of interrogation details based on raids in the last few days and depositions. These documents have never before been seen, ladies and gentlemen, and they point to a massive payoff for protection plan. Investigators elicit shocking details. Let's break it. Investigators are eliciting shocking details. Detained Hurriyat leaders cough up names, top state officials bought by Pakistani money. That's right. Even officials today have been bought in Jammu and Kashmir by Pakistani money. Times Now withholds two top names in the national interest because they're still being investigated. But we can tell you that these individuals in the police force were paid to protect Hurriyat leaders. In a sense, were paid to ensure that these Hurriyat leaders were tipped off before raids or before impending investigations. Editor Internal Security Nikunj Garg has more details, and I want to draw him in on this. Nikunj, the papers we have, the details we know, point towards a massive scandal where officials, government machinery, paid off for protection.
Well, absolutely, Rahul. And these are facts that are now being investigated by the National Investigative Agency. And these are facts which will be submitted by the National Investigative Agency to the Ministry of Home Affairs for further action by the state government. If the state officers in the state cadre are involved, those officials will have to be dealt by the state government. If the officials of the All India Service cadres are involved, then the Ministry of Home Affairs would be in a position to take direct action against them. Now, Rahul, we had known it from the very beginning, but we had not put it out because it was an ongoing operation. But now that the operation has concluded in the sense that those seven Hurriyat leaders are behind the bars in the National Investigative Agency's headquarters, they have also been produced in a court of law. The court has put its first seal of approval in granting a police custody remand to NIA. Now we can inform our viewers that there was a fracas that played out at the very last moment when these six Hurriyat leaders were being transported from Srinagar to New Delhi in the custody of the National Investigating Agency officials. Now, this drama played out at the airport itself. There were ranking officials on whose directions, ranking officials in the state law enforcement machinery, on whose directions state police reached the airport and in a way tried to stop the National Investigative Agency from bringing these Hurriyat leaders to New Delhi. Now, a National Investigating Agency obviously probing this further as to why it happened, how the law enforcement agencies' wires got crossed with each other, has certainly found out that there are individuals who were actually paid off paid off with the same money that Hurriyat receives from Pakistan, paid off from the same blood money on which the generations of Kashmiris have been lost, and for which generals in Rawalpindi should actually face a genocide and a human rights trial for spoiling generations of Kashmiris. This same money changed hands, and you know, this was not only for the fact that, you know, these Hurriyat leaders would be protected, but also for the fact that, remember Rahul, National Investigative Agency and also to a large extent Central Bureau of Investigation will have to depend, particularly in carrying out searches and raids.
Well, let
in
me tell you,
locations and
till
on
now, Nikunj,
people
one
and
had thought, till now, Nikunj, one had thought that some of the patronage that was coming the way of the Hurriyat leadership was coming their way because there was just general political goodwill invested in them or disposed upon them. But now it seems that they were paying for some of this goodwill. And this is really shocking, because these are government officials. These are individuals who are supposed to uphold the integrity, both territorial and political, of the Indian state. But they themselves perhaps were colluding with the Hurriyat to ensure that their activities went unnoticed. It doesn't end at that. Breaking angle two is even bigger. It's even bigger because it casts aspersions on friends in the social sphere. Yes, there are individuals who have actually been assisting the Hurriyat by blacking out news which was negative to the Hurriyat. So, for example, there were some vendors, news vendors, that refused to report news about their arrests, crackdown, and the reasons behind the crackdown and the arrests, which is shocking. What we are being told is a secret report on media coverage has been accessed. Investigators unearthed bribe for blackout scam. Top editors paid to blackout negative news on the Hurriyat. All of this available here. So this just suggests that look at the spectrum, from government officials to media. And that's why we called it the code of silence. Because if you don't have an administrative authority that is prosecuting and you don't have a media that is reporting, if they're all bought out, then the truth can never surface. And I want to go back to Nikunj. Nikunj, I don't know which is worse. I don't know which is worse tonight.
Well, yes, Rahul, this is a secret analysis of the particularly the social media coverage and particularly the online coverage which agencies have made. And, you know, it is not to snoop or not to keep an eye on media organizations, or for that matter, you know, find faults with media organizations' coverage, that this has been done. But this analysis is important from the point of view that the Pakistani deep state is very much active on social media and always picks on the issues that are there, critical to our national security apparatus, critical and sensitive to our national security interests. And therefore, this analysis was prepared, particularly because this was a first of its kind, first time ever kind of crackdown. And that's what government was keen to know as to what is going on behind the scenes to help these individuals who are actually nothing but Pakistan's agent in Kashmir Valley. So in this secret social media analysis that we have seen and we have accessed, it's very clear that with an intent, because what happens is when you inform the viewers about the crackdown, you also have to inform them about the reasons.
Absolutely.
You also have to tell them that why the agencies were forced to take this step, and that is the reason for the blackout. You don't want to give out the news critical to these.
And what is it that the Hurriyat was trying to suppress?
Reason.
This is detail, and I want to go across to Anand Narasimhan, a senior editor who joins us. Anand Narasimhan, now we have been able to establish the letter trail, haven't we, from terror organizations to the Hurriyat.
Yes.
This is damning. This has never been revealed. We had these papers yesterday. We couldn't put the story out because of the big breaking political development. But the fact of the matter is that the Hizbul Mujahideen, the Lashkar-e-Toyba, have been writing to the Hurriyat. It's not just the ISI funneling money, but there were individuals who were writing from terror organizations to the aides, the closest aides of Syed Ali Shah Gilani and Mirwais Umar Farooq, individuals who are today responsible for the death of braves in the valley, of patriotic Kashmiris who stand up and salute the Indian tricolor. Now I want to ask you, what are the details you have, Anand?
Well, let's go. I have three letters with me, Rahul. The first letter is dated the 17th of March 2006. Hizbul Mujahideen, Jammu and Kashmir. That's what it's titled. And it says, Assalamu alaikum, and it is addressed to Mohtaram Naeem Sahib. This is Naeem Khan, key aide of Syed Ali Shah Gilani. And what they are asking is, Meherbani ke liye 7,000-10,000 rupay mujhe de dein. This is what itiyati zarurat, because we've got troubles, and to alleviate our problems, you please give us 7,000 to 10,000 rupees. And then they're also saying that we will hold back a mobile phone, which we will give it to you later. Thank you very much. And this is written by the area commander Burkhan. So very clearly, even in the early 2000, even in 2006, the Hurriyat was openly backing terror outfits like the Hizbul and the Lashkar. This is Hizbul Mujahideen. This has been written from... This is the letterhead of the Hizbul Mujahideen, and this letter is in Urdu. That's letter seeking. There you go. Financial assistance from Naeem Khan. This is another letter which has come from the head office in Muzaffarabad of the Lashkar-e-Toyba. It's written in Urdu, which is demanding 5,000 rupees from Shahidul Islam.
Right.
This is the letterhead, Hope, and I have the Hindi translation for that, and I'll show that to our viewers in just a bit, where they're asking for 5,000 rupees help. And who is Shahidul Islam? Rahul, Shahidul Islam is very close to Mirwais Umar Farooq. He's a key aide, close associate. He's a former Hezbollah commander. He was involved in dirty financial business for Mirwais Umar Farooq, both in Kashmir and in Pakistan. So this is the man. To him, it is written, Lashkar-e-Toyba, Jammu and Kashmir, head office, Muzaffarabad. Letter written in 2007 is what we are given to understand. That's what it shows here. And here, what they are asking is 5,000 rupees, because one of their aides is ill.
Okay,
for their treatment, they want 5,000 rupees.
That's really immaterial. The fact is...
Aapka Gajlavi Tarjuman
Lashkar-e-Toyba. Absolutely, the fact is, Anand, that money has been changing hands.
And yes.
It's been going from the Hurriyat conference to the terrorists. Where do the Hurriyat get it from? From Pakistan ISI. So basically, the Hurriyat conference is a front office for the ISI and the ATM machine. ATM machine for terror organizations who are committed to attacking India, bleeding India through 1,000 cuts. Let me just open this out, because at 8:30 it gets even bigger, ladies and gentlemen. A video for the first time revealed the Kashmir Caliphate cadre, now on Indian soil. Never before seen video. We'll be playing that out at 8:30. Stay tuned for that. I want to throw this open. GVR Narasimha Rao is with me. RSN Singh, Colonel RSN Singh is also there. Babar Qadri, a lawyer. Majid Haidri, another lawyer and activist. Mehmood Paracha, another senior lawyer, is with us. You'll need all your wits to defend the Hurriyat tonight, gentlemen. But I want to first go across to GVR Narasimha Rao. GVR Narasimha Rao, first, the government deserves to be congratulated for doing what very few have done in the past, which is locking up these agents of Pakistan, these dalals of Pakistan.
Yeah, Rahul, I think for a very long time, the country had a very soft approach towards dealing with separatists and all PAK-sponsored activities in this country. We've also seen in the past how the entire seminar circuit in this country, how a large number of pseudo-intellectuals, a number of well-known journalists, how they have all been feted, how they have been ferried all over the world to speak to toe the Pakistani line. I think that is nothing short of actually sedition, because you've seen how Pakistan used its money power to buy a lot of voices in India.
Yes.
To really toe a Pakistani line. And you see that happen even till date. You see people attacking the Indian army chief. You see people how they are siding with separatists at a time when their Pakistan links have been laid bare, at a time when they have been using money to create disturbances in the valley. I think you have political parties, leaders, intellectuals, journalists all siding with them and making all the pro-Pak noises. So all this was happening all this while with a lot of prodding from Pakistan and with a lot of funding from Pakistan.
This
so I think it's important that I think this government, like you said, certainly needs congratulated to take this bull by the horns.
Well, this so-called alienation now we can establish is funded. And I want to bring you in, Mr. Babar Qadri. And I want to ask you first to make a complete disclosure. And I have to ask this question. This is not with prejudice to you, Mr. Qadri, but because we have reported that certain individuals are being funded to fly the banner for the Hurriyat. I'm going to ask you, sir, are you one of those who gets money from the Hurriyat conference to fly their banner? Because that's what we are being told. So I would like you to come out in public and say, yes, I'm proud to receive money from the Hurriyat. I support them because I'm paid to do so. No problems. Make full disclosure.
Let me tell you honestly that I have let me disclose everything. I have not attended a single conference or their meeting since 2010. You can check it. One. Second, let me give you some information that is meant for which this program is meant. I tell you honestly, by bringing in these disclosures and these exposés during these times, you are not helping Indians. You are actually helping the pro-freedom resistance, because our conviction is strengthened by your dirty acts, the way you are doing it. NIA has three implications. First, you are attacking 370. Second, you doubt
one second, police. Babar Qadri,
third,
isn't it a fact that these individuals own these mansions in the capital,
mansions
outside
of Kashmir,
in plush pockets of Haryana? Isn't it a fact? Where have they got this money from? What businesses they do? You tell me, instead of running up and down throwing stones in the streets, where are they getting this money from?
Sir, let me tell you honestly, if at all this is proven and it is true that
Hurriyat
has amassed
wealth. It is true. They live in mansions.
They are criminals up
there. Even in the valley, they live in mansions.
Indians have nothing to do with it. Indians have nothing to do with it because you are occupiers. You leave Kashmir, leave it to us and we'll teach them lesson.
Why don't you do one thing? Since you're so passionately committed to the cause, and since you have such a problem with India, why do you work in this country?
I don't have any problem with India.
Mr. Qadri, why do you feed off the Indian taxpayer? Why don't you go across the valley? Why don't you just go across, join your brothers in occupied lands like POK? Why don't you live there? Why don't you,
one second. That's also a problem.
Do you speak for, Kashmiris or do you speak for Pakistanis? Let me ask you that second question. Kashmiris or Pakistanis?
I think of Kashmiris. I am bothered of Kashmir.
Okay, so 1 minute. Let me ask you.
I have a problem
Qadri,
with Indian
one second. Relax.
There is another stakeholder.
So can I ask you a question?
We have to engage with both of
you. Okay, Mr. Qadri, can I ask you a question, sir? Without you shouting your lungs out and making me also project my voice, can we have some peace? Let me ask you a question then. So when Pakistanis kill innocent Kashmiris, when your brothers on the other side of the Yellow Sea protest against the Pakistani state, why don't you ever come out and condemn Pakistani terror? Let me finish my question. I have a part two to my question.
Violation, I will condemn it.
Excuse me, Mr. Qadri. When the Lashkar-e-Toyba,
they are free to protest.
Qadri,
when they protest, we will
Mr.
support
Qadri,
them.
But, no, okay, one
but
second.
My question is you.
Mr. Qadri, one second. Can I just finish?
You bear my question. One question I have for you.
But today, you haven't allowed me to finish my question.
You gave amnesty to armed people who killed people in Mathil.
Can I finish asking you my...
What is answer to that question?
Can you allow me to ask you the second question, which is just as relevant as the first? Now, you know...
You first answer my question.
The Lashkar-e-Toyba, the Hizbul Mujahideen...
Why you gave clean shit to armed people who killed
excuse
innocent
me,
people in Mathil?
Mr. Qadri, relax.
They were convicted by your court. They were convicted
by your
court.
Are you here to shout? Are you here to scream? Or are you here to debate? Are you here to shout? Are you here to scream? Or are you here to debate? If you're not, then if you're not interested in a debate, then why don't you just exit the panel? At least allow for a proper debate. You want answers. You're asking questions, but you're not going to allow anyone to speak. So, Mr. Qadri, I want to ask you. Kashmiris are also dying. There are a large number of Kashmiris from the police force who are being butchered by terrorists who come from Pakistan, right? I don't hear you and the pictures are on our screen. There is a very brave soldier who was lynched outside a mosque where Mirwais Umar Farooq was holding forth on one of the holiest days of the Muslim calendar. Now, one second, sir.
I condemn that.
One second.
But
I have never heard you come out and say that Mirwais Umar Farooq has shamed Kashmir. That Gilani has shamed Kashmir by 1 minute by funding these terrorists.
Answer?
You take a position. You take a position.
I will take a position. I will take a position. Those who sent that DSP to Masjid that time under those circumstances without protection, with pistol, they should be first booked. Then those persons who lynched him,
Colonel Anderson, you hear that? Colonel Anderson, you hear that? You hear the man who can't stand up for the human rights of his brother Kashmiris? Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. Colonel Harrison.
He's a global jihadi. Disgusting.
I tell you, it was government was responsible. It is government that was responsible to send that person that place. Without protection.
You are creating out of NIA probe.
You know, Colonel Harrison. NIA probe. 1 minute. Haidri sahab,
Can I now?
Yes, Colonel Harrison.
Can I?
Yes, go ahead.
Can I? Yes. Yes, Rahul, the Huriyat is the linchpin of terrorism and proxy war in Kashmir and consequently in the rest of India, because what is happening in Kashmir has increasing reverberations all over the country. Now, here is an organization, I said, which was a linchpin with links to Islamabad, with links to Rawalpindi, with the military intelligence establishment of Pakistan, with links to the jihadi tanzeems based in Pakistan, with links in the Pakistan embassy, with links in the terror groups operating within Kashmir, and links with mainstream political parties within the valley.
Government of India and is a links, part of that dalali.
Shut up now.
New Delhi is part of that dalali.
Haidri, do you see letters?
Supra, baat karne do. Tabhi
no, why shouldn't I say? This is dalali going on. This what NIA is the yes, ploy.
Supra!
Why are you not directing those PDP ministers?
1 minute.
Dalals of Hawala.
The Huriyat Conference, these are letters. Deny the letters.
1 minute.
Deny the letters. Afzal Guru writes to Gilani.
Will I be allowed to speak?
Is he the grandfather of terror in the valley?
You shut up. It's my turn.
I'm asking you.
Dalali from New Delhi.
Why is...
It's my turn to speak. You shut up.
Why is Afzal Guru, sir, writing... No, Mr. Haidri, you first answer the question.
Not being questioned.
Excuse me. Haidri, I will have to lower your fader because you're just going to keep derailing. Now, let me...
Listen.
1 minute. Let me ask him the question.
Yeah, Colonel, Rahul, 1 second. Colonel, Rahul, if I'm not allowed to speak, I'll keep quiet.
1 second, Colonel. 1 second. Let me confront him with some facts. Here are the facts, Mr. Haidri. Mr. Haidri, you see in my hand, a letter which has been written by Afzal Guru to Mr. Gilani. There is a letter that has been written by the Hizbul Mujahideen and the Lashkar-e-Toyba. The Hizbul Mujahideen is writing to an individual who is close to both the Huriyat leader and the top brass. Why are these letters being written? If the Huriyat is not a sympathizer and promoter and patron of terror, answer me this.
Sir, let me reply you. There is one more authentic letter written by Afzal Guru, which was published by...
Will I be allowed to speak?
Go ahead.
Will I be allowed to speak?
Go ahead, sir.
Attack.
Go
Why
ahead.
Was he never questioned? Just because he...
Go ahead.
Yeah, what I was saying is... What I was saying... That it was always very big. The footprints were always very big. Everybody knew about it. There was nothing complicated. But there was nothing complicated and intriguing about it. But the serious question here, Rahul, is that how the people who are responsible, who are the linchpin of proxy war and terror in Kashmir, how were they allowed to prosper in security? Security provided by our agencies and the state.
Let me ask.
And when...
The let RB me ask Mr. Mehmood Paracha this question.
About two and a half front, let me tell you. This half front is very, very dangerous. These are the representatives. These are the, proxy soldiers of that half front. And aiding them are some people in the government, in the media. Let me tell you, there is no security problem in this country.
Let me ask Mehmood Paracha.
Is intractable.
Mehmood Paracha.
But we have allowed it to continue. We have allowed it to continue because it's an industry.
It is. And people are on the pay. People are on the pay and this is going to get exposed. Names of journalists, names of police officers, names of government babus will be all out very soon. And we will see how widespread this is. So all those who walk around campuses and all those who have been taking to the streets, writing open letters to governors, etc. Watch out. You might be exposed. Mr. Paracha, I'm coming to you. Mr. Paracha, you're supposed to be a reasonable man. Here is documented evidence. Documented evidence of the Hizbul Mujahideen writing to the Hurriyat Conference. Documented evidence of the Lashkar-e-Toiba writing to the Hurriyat Conference. Documented letters of Afzal Guru written to Sayyid Ali Shah Gilani. Why? Is it because the Hurriyat and the grandees in the Hurriyat are the patrons of terror? Why are people asking for money from them? Tell me, Mr. Paracha.
Rahul, please allow me a bit of time so that I can make my point fully. Because if you don't allow me, then I will not be able to make my entire point.
No, it depends on only if you answer the question.
For the first time,
why are these individuals writing to all these people? And if terrorists are writing to the Hurriyat, should the Hurriyat not be banned? And should the Hurriyat, most importantly, not be dismissed as a terror organization? Very quickly answer that question. Pointed question to you.
My answer has always been that this is too late and too little.
I am answering your question. I'm not asking you for a discourse on politics. Mr. Paracha, answer the question. You're a man of the law, and I think that you're a respectable man of the law. If there is documented evidence of requests that have been made and requests that have been complied with,
consider that
for one second, for funds
to
execute terror attacks or funds to patronize, to patronize terrorism, then should the Hurriyat not be banned and put on the list of proscribed terror organizations? Simple question. Paracha.
My answer is with a question. Why has it not been banned till date is my question. And I've been asking this question.
Because the evidence is coming out now.
That is the question.
G.V.L. Narasimha Rao, would you like to take that? G.V.L. Narasimha Rao might want to take that.
That is what is shameful.
G.V.L. Narasimha Rao, would you like to answer him? Maybe you need to enlighten this man who is in a deep sense of denial.
Let me finish this.
I think Kashmiris are alienated from you.
No, listen to me. And these evidences are not evidences once again. These evidences are for the gallery. Let us see what the charge sheet will be. Rahul, do not miss this point. We have to first see what the charge sheet is.
When you want to defend somebody, NIA, as a shrewd lawyer, you would consider any evidence as inadmissible.
As a responsible citizen,
what is your stand on this? Do you approve of actions of these separatists?
My stand is it is...
Do you approve? Before you tell us to take action, tell me as a responsible citizen, what do you think of their actions?
This is too late. This is failure of the government.
Shocking.
No, this is
shocking. We have a man of law who is speaking like an apologist for terrorists. And I'm shocked by you, Mr. Paracha. I think you need to be investigated, actually. We're going to take a short break. When we return, we're going to pick out... We are going to pick out the lies, the mendacity in some of the responses I'm getting today. We're going to take a short break. Also coming up, the Caliphate Crusaders have arrived. They're on Indian soil. They're armed and dangerous. And their video captures their designs. Coming back to that. Well, the Hurriyat is on the way out. Its leadership is being arrested. The Lashkar-e-Toiba and the Hizbul Mujahideen are being thwarted. And you might be actually wondering if India is beginning to win the war against terror. But that would be too premature a conclusion to reach, because before our security forces can pat themselves on the back, they need to watch this video that has come through. This is the fight for the caliphate. Kashmir caliphate cadre sworn to imposing a caliphate in Srinagar. And of course, the state is here. For the first time, you're seeing pictures of the Kashmir caliphate cadre. This is the Al-Qaeda. It's announcing its new leader and its new cadre, the Al-Qaeda, sworn to the establishment under Osama bin Laden of an emir and also a Muslim homeland where the Sharia will hold sway, not the constitution. These are the pictures, ladies and gentlemen, of the distortion of the diabolism that has landed on Kashmir soil. This is a real and clearly present danger, and it presents a warped worldview. And I want to ask Colonel RSN what he makes of all of this. Before that, if I can go across to Pradeep. Pradeep, this video, we're going to try and connect to Pradeep, who has actually accessed this video. Pradeep is there with us. Pradeep, just talk us through this video. The Islamic Caliphate via the Al-Qaeda is here. It's on Indian soil. Physical evidence for the first time ever of that on our screens.
See, the security agencies had been talking about this for quite some time, but now it is official that they have, Al-Qaeda has announced their terror wing that is called Ghazwa, Ansar Ghazwatul Hind, and they have made Zakir Musa as their new commander. Zakir Musa is the former Hizbul Mujahideen chief. He last month had in fact lashed out at the Hurriyat leadership because he had shown a total shift, ideological shift from the Kashmir nationalism or Azadi towards the caliphate. He is talking about Sharia and he's talking about Shahadat. Sharia means Islamic law and Shahadat means sacrificing their life for the establishment of Sharia. So this is a total ideological shift, and this, as you are rightly said, this has rattled in fact both Hizbul Mujahideen and Lashkar-e-Toyba also, because the Hizbul Mujahideen was talking about Azadi or annexation of Kashmir with Pakistan. But now this is a total ideological shift that has rattled even the global designated terrorist Sayyid Salahuddin. So this clearly indicates that now Al-Qaeda is trying to spread its tentacles, because this man, Zakir Musa, is the new commander who is calling the shots. It is not the Sayyid Salahuddin. Sayyid Salahuddin had been there for the last 3 decades. He seems to have lost his sheen. Now it is Zakir Musa, because we have seen that last time one of the, in fact, terrorists got killed. His body, normally they wrap the body of the terrorist with Pakistani flag. But that time it was seen that following the instructions from Zakir Musa, one of the person who was accompanying the body, he threw away Pakistani flag and instead he wrapped the body with the ISIS flag. So that clearly showed a kind of a shift. And here in this video, now it is officially established.
Well, what have we proven, Pradeep? What have we proven? We have proven over the last 40 minutes, or well, to be exact, 38 minutes, we have proven that the so-called alienation that exists in the mind of Kashmiris is funded by Pakistan. That alienation is funded. And that the aspirations, the so-called aspirations of the Kashmiri people, the unfulfilled aspirations of the Kashmiri people, have been hijacked now by Islamist radicals. Their aspirations toward an Azadi is gone, it's finished. It has been hijacked, it's been cannibalized, and I want to bring in Colonel RSN, and I want to bring in Mahmood Parucha, individuals, at least as far as I know, Mr. Paracha, an apologist for this kind of warped view of Islam. But first, Colonel RSN, this is something that was talked about. Today we have the video evidence in front of us. Colonel RSN.
Rahul, let me decipher things for you. Firstly, there is nothing called a local jihadi group. All groups are global jihadi groups. The priorities may differ. In the case of Pakistan-based jihadi groups like Lashkar-e-Toyba and others, you know, Jaish-e-Mohammed and all, their priority, it is, you know, to serve the appetite of Pakistan and China. China, you know, that appetite for territory. That is why you will never find any Kashmiri leader speaking one word against China or, you know, the treatment of Muslims in the Xinjiang province by the Chinese.
Mr. Paracha, you need to condemn this.
Just a minute. Now, in this case, you know, I am not at all surprised. The head of the Al-Qaeda in Indian subcontinent is one Asif Umar. And Asif Umar, if you map his journey, jihadi journey, he started from, you know, Darul Uloom from Deoband, went to that famous, you know, Binori Mosque in Karachi,
yes,
whose products are, you know, Masood Azhar, Mullah Omar and Abdul Aziz of,
shocking,
you know, of Lal Masjid fame. From there, this man goes to, you know, the POK camps, training camps. And then, you know, educate, you know, indoctrinates them in global
jihad. Well, sir, all I can say today to the apologists of the Zakir Naiks and the Zakir Musa is that they better rescue Kashmiriyat because it's dying. There is nothing called inclusivity. There is a warped worldview, and these individuals need to come out and condemn it.
And as far as Shariat is concerned, let me tell you,
Mehmood Paracha,
there are lawyers in the panel. You ask them, do they believe
allow
in
me
Sharia?
To make a point, no?
Do they believe
allow me
in
to
Sharia?
Make a point.
No, no, one second, Mr. Paracha, do you believe in the Sharia or do you believe in the constitution and the law of the land?
Identity for Indian law.
But if you,
so these lawyers,
can you allow me to say something?
You know, behind them, they should throw it away. और मैं आपको एक और बता देता हूँ शरीयत लॉ के बारे में.
Till
today, no hands have been chopped off in Pakistan for stealing. Do you know that?
Kashmiri.
There is a parallel.
Let me ask Mr. Paracha. Let me ask Mr. Paracha. Mr. Paracha, and I'm asking you this question. Do you believe in Sharia or do you believe in the Indian law? And I'm asking you this very clear, flat off. No, no, one second.
When it comes to marriage,
These are the pictures, these are the soldiers of those who want to impose a regressive culture, worldview, Islamist philosophy on this soil. So I'm asking you this question. Take a position, Mr. Paracha, please. Take a position today. Rescue. Rescue Kashmiriyat. Rescue your faith.
I believe in both, and Indian constitution permits me to follow Sharia. That is the answer. Now let me come to the point. Let us, all of us, people in India, stop patting our backs because our Kashmir policy is a failure. It is an absolute failure. Let me see the results of the ground level. Stop patting your back. Government is not doing enough.
If somebody is not stealing, his hand should be chopped off. Do you subscribe to that? Otherwise, you throw away these law books. If you believe in Sharia, your fidelity in the Indian constitution can never be there. You are a liar.
Mr. Paracha.
जहाँ आयाशी का मामला है, जब शादी करनी और डिवोर्स करनी है, तो शरीयत चाहिए. और चोरी के जो सऊदी अरेबिया में हाथ काट दिए जाते हैं, उसके लिए शरीयत नहीं चाहिए. अरे किसको बेवकूफ बना रहे हो यार?
You need to respond to this.
तुम्हारे जैसे
because this is precisely the reason why you have a situation where a faith committed, where a faith committed to peace
ask him to lower
is being, no, that's not the answer. Mr. Paracha, you need to take a position.
What he's saying.
Why are you so keen? Why are you so keen?
Ask him to lower his voice.
Mr. Paracha, you need to respond to me.
Ask him to lower his voice.
You need to respond, Mr. Paracha. We're not going anywhere. I'll move on to another panelist.
Please keep quiet for some time.
Okay. I don't think Mr. Paracha wants to answer.
No.
I want to go across. Okay, I want to go straight across. He doesn't want to answer. He's dodging the question.
What is the question?
The question, can I ask you?
I can't hear.
Let me ask you the question, Mr. Paracha.
You tell me what the question
okay.
is.
Okay, don't deal with him. Just shut him down because he's not interested. Let me go across. Let me go across to Majid Haidari. Majid Haidari, I'm asking you a simple question. Colonel Alison, 1 second, please. I need to come in here. Mr. Majid Haidari, a simple question. Why are you so keen on giving Pakistan a huge, big, clean chit? Why is it that when you see a new form of terror that is arriving, which is being primed by the ISI, why is it that you defend it? Why is it that you can't condemn it? Why is it that we always say that the Indian state has failed? How about apportioning some of that blame on Islamabad? Answer me.
Rahul, I have never been pro-Pakistan or Pakistani supporter.
So take
Let
a position.
First thing, What the problem is...
No. You take a position.
That a group of
you say that Pakistan should be condemned now, and declared a terror state for exporting terror.
Government of India
Mr. Haidari wants Kashmiri youth to get guns and get killed.
The policy and the conspiracy of Government of India and to say the saffron forces and the terror brigade at the helm.
Mr. Haidari, can I ask you a question, a counter question?
Sir, kindly.
Tell me, in Afghanistan, has the Afghanistan state failed or has Pakistan succeeded in exporting terror and destabilizing that country? Answer me that question.
Let's prioritize.
No, I'm asking you.
Kashmir.
You answer the question.
Big problem, Kashmir.
You answer the question. Let me ask you, in Afghanistan...
These are assumptions.
No, why don't you answer? This is the problem. You see, you can never take a position against Pakistan. You will not take a position against Pakistan, and therefore I asked you, are you one of those who gets money? Are you one of those who gets money from Pakistan? You need to answer. Answer me. Are you one of those who gets paid off by Pakistan, Mr. Haidari? And if you don't take a position, say that Pakistan exports terror into Afghanistan, into India, and is butchering Kashmiris in POK.
Who get paid by both sides? It is your BJP, which is paying on both sides.
Mr. Haidari,
don't label me as this. I have never taken even a penny from either Indian or Pakistani side.
So then, Mr. Haidari, it should not be a problem for you.
And I continue to be so.
Then,
but the problem is BJP is giving money. BJP is into dalali, and you don't. Want to discuss
where
that.
You don't have to make any mental effort, you know. You
okay.
know,
stop this nonsense.
You are so, you are a... So,
yeah, GBN Nasimara wants to come in.
Do you have an iota?
Sir.
Do you have tolerance?
Had you been aware of Shariat, you would know that if India would take inspiration from Shariat, there would
Mr. GV Narasimha.
Today, India is known as rapist.
Rahul, can I ask him to keep quiet? Can I get in a word? Mr. Haidari, can I get in a word? I think it's we find it so appalling. Why don't the panelists who come on television, whom we have to confront every day, why don't you call a spade a spade? Why can't you express yourself against the kind of radicalization that's going on there? Why do you have to put your religion above everything else? For you, does the nation not come first? Does the welfare of your own state and your own community, does it not come above your religion? I think at a time when the whole region, you have Afghanistan, you have Bangladesh, you have Iraq, all of them are Muslim countries. They all point towards Pakistan as a terror exporting factory. All the neighboring countries, the Islamic countries of Pakistan, Islamic neighboring countries, I think point a finger towards Pakistan. But why do you, people coming from Kashmir on the panel, and people coming from the Muslim faith from rest of the country, why do you become apologists for Pakistan? Why do you start speaking for the terrorists? Why do you speak for the separatists? I think, can you not put your own self-interest, your own interest of your own people above your religion?
Let's get Mr. Paracha to respond. Mr. Paracha, I'm sure you've heard this.
No,
if you're still tone deaf,
media discourse is proving.
Mr. Paracha,
I'm talking about the people who come on television. I'm not saying that is not the public discourse.
Okay.
People who come on television here, I think are actually setting a wrong agenda for the Muslim community in the country.
Let me get Mr. Paracha to respond.
You become the spokespersons for them. You defend Zakir Naik. You defend Zakir Musa. You defend Syed Salahuddin. You defend Pakistan, which no other country in the world wants to defend.
Okay, let me get Haidari to respond to that. Mr. Haidari, go ahead. Sure. Respond.
Sir, I have been defending Dr. Zakir Naik because he has been an iconic peace preacher, and I'll continue to defend him. There was nothing against him but a fabricated case by
what
which he
iconic?
Was concocted.
I think is
I
it
mean,
not
for
the
that
world
matter,
knows.
Yogi Adityanath has 10 criminal cases registered against him.
I think you prove me right again.
147, IPC 148, IPC 307, IPC 353.
Let me get Colonel Arison to respond to you. Colonel Arison.
Anti-Shia like Zakir Naik. Yeah, are you anti-Shia like Zakir Naik? Will you say the madam must Kalandar Alida pehla number? Bologe?
Are you anti-Shia? Bolo. Are you anti-Sunni?
Bologe.
What is this, sir? Why you want
Bologe.
To send Muslims? Why you want to send them to Pakistan?
Nahi, bolo na.
We want to kill all
you are propagating a particular type of Islam which is consuming the entire world.
Divide Muslims.
For sake of Shia, your Shia brothers.
Divide Muslims.
For sake of your Shia brothers.
Hindus don't.
In India and all over the world.
United.
Please repeat with me.
United.
The madam must Kalandar Ali da pehla number. Bolo.
Yes. क्यों
बोलो
हम तो बोलते हैं कैसे
नौटंकी है जाकिर नायक से नौटंकी करवा रहे
आज यू आर पार्ट ऑफ द नौटंकी है जेंटलमैन वन सेकंड लेट मी कम इन हियर व्हाट वी हैव हियर इज अ सिचुएशन वेयर इन द फेस ऑफ द ग्रेवेस्ट प्रोवोकेशन वेयर इन द फेस एंड वी कैन सी दिस इन द फेस ऑफ एविडेंस हियर ऑफ लिंक्स बिटवीन टेरर ग्रुप्स एंड द हुरियत कॉन्फ्रेंस देयर आर इंडिविजुअल्स हु आर स्टिल स्वॉर्न टू डिफेंडिंग द हुरियत The Hurriyat outlook, and worst of all, Rahul, the Hurriyat's agenda, which is diabolical. You have Mahmood Paracha, who in the rights, in the interest of upholding human rights, comes out and says to us that, oh well, these individuals are being targeted. The proof is here, ladies and gentlemen. Mahmood Paracha, you have 30 seconds to tell me, 30 seconds to tell me today that you will condemn Pakistan for fueling terror on Indian soil, for fueling terror in Afghanistan, for fueling terror in other parts of the world, including Iran. You have 30 seconds to take that position, and that Pakistan should be declared a rogue state. I'm asking you, yeah. Take a position.
Let me know when my 30 seconds starts.
Oh, come on,
my
end
position
the charade,
about
begin
Pakistan
your answer.
Is that Pakistan is a very weak enemy, and we as a strong nation have failed to tackle a very weak enemy, and we should accept our failure. So, and pull up our socks and try to tackle it. It's a weak government, it's a weak country, and it is our responsibility to tackle Pakistan.
Apologies.
And that is one. And I think
apologists who can't take a position against Pakistan.
For the first time
as
a good action, but simultaneously,
now you can see
we should
how deep the Hurriyat conference has penetrated. Its tentacles
Pakistan is a small country. It's
their,
our failure.
No,
we are not able to tackle
one
it.
One second. Tentacles of the Hurriyat are wrapped around
see,
a large
see,
number of individuals who are,
we are
educated
we
on the face of
it
in our society. So much so that these
and
individuals cannot
see,
come out and take a position against the Hurriyat's patron, which is of course Pakistan. Here you have a situation, ladies and gentlemen, and this is exposing the larger community, the ecosystem that thrives off the Hurriyat and is committed to advancing the cause of the Hurriyat. You have a situation here where, in the face of evidence linking the Hizbul Mujahideen to the Hurriyat conference, the Lashkar-e-Toyba to the Hurriyat conference, letters that have been written by individuals who are close to both Mirwais Umar Farooq and Gilani of the Hurriyat conference, and most importantly, letters that have been written by terrorists to other subordinates in the Hurriyat hierarchy. Despite all this evidence, you have individuals today who have been suborned to such a degree that they are finding it difficult to take a position against Pakistan and in India's interests. They are still blabbering on and on. And it just goes to show the spread, really, of the disease that the Indian state is up against. We're going to take a short break. Navika Kumar is with us with a special edition of the News Hour. Navika, over to you.